Hello friends, in this video I am going to discuss about torque transmitting capacity of single plate clutch. You know, clutches transmit power from engine to gearbox. That means it transmits torque from engine to gearbox. So I am going to derive the equation for torque transmitting capacity of single plate clutch. First consider a friction disc. So draw your friction disc. So the inner radius of friction disc is ri, and outer radius is ro. This is the side view of this friction disc. So on friction disc, pressure P is acting on friction disc. So P is the intensity of pressure acting on this disc at radius r, and another load is acting, that is total operating load, that is W, total operating load W. Now for the derivation, consider a elemental area. So elemental ring, we have to consider here elemental ring of radius r. This is the elemental ring of radius r. So this is the elemental ring of radius r, and thickness dr. Thickness of this ring is dr. Now ro is the outer radius of friction disc. Ro is the outer radius of friction disc. Also ri is the inner radius of friction disc. Then P is the intensity of pressure at radius r. Intensity of pressure at radius r. W is a total operating force in Newton. So pressure in Newton per mm square, ro in mm, ri in mm. Now torque T is a torque transmitted by clutch in Newton mm. Assume the elemental ring of radius r and thickness dr. Assume elemental ring of radius r and thickness dr. So the operating force acting on this ring, if ring is here is the ring. So operating force acting on this ring is dw. So dw, we have to find this dw. So dw is equal to, so we know pressure is equal to force divided by area. So force is equal to pressure into area. So pressure intensity into the circumferential area, perimeter area of this ring is, perimeter area is 2 pi r into thickness dr. So this is the elemental axial force dw. So now total operating force w is equal to, you have to take integral of this dw, so that you can get the total axial force. So integral from ri to RO, we can get total axial force. So now put the value of dW from integral from RI to RO 2 pi r p into 2 pi r dr. So 2 pi p is constant, so take outside, then RI to RO r dr. Now this is the total axial force. So 2 pi p integral from RI to RO r dr. This is the total axial force or total operating force acting on this friction disk. Now to find out the torque, two theories are used in single plate clutch or in clutch. So one is a uniform pressure theory and another one is uniform wear theory. So uniform pressure theory, in case of new clutches, the pressure remains constant over the entire surface area of the friction disk. So that in new clutches, the pressure, uniform pressure theory is used. So the same diagram is for uniform pressure theory. So let us see uniform. First theory is uniform pressure theory to find out the torque transmitting capacity. Two theories are used. This is uniform pressure theory, which is used in new clutches. So we know that axial elemental force, the total axial force, you know the equation for total axial force, W is equal to 2 pi p integral from RI to RO r dr. Now take an integral 2 pi p, so integral of r is r square divided by 2 from RI to RO. So 2 pi p, so we know that RO square minus RI square divided by 2. So 2 to cancel, so pi p RO square minus RI square. So this is W. So therefore P is equal to, this 2R goes to denominator, so W divided by pi RO square minus RI square. So this is the, if this is a equation 1, take this is a equation 2, this is equation 3. Now we have to find torque transmitting capacity. So we know the tangential force on elemental ring. So tangential force dFT is nothing but mu W. Tangential force is nothing but frictional force, and friction force is mu into dW. So dW we know, so dFT is equal to mu into so dt is equal to dft we find out. So dt, now torque transmitting capacity or torque transmitted by clutch by this elemental ring, dt is equal to dft into radius of this radius r. Now dt is equal to, put the value of dt here, dft here, so mu dw into r, mu dw into r. Now total torque transmitted t is equal to integral dft into r. So t is equal to integral mu dw into r. So mu is constant, so take out from the integral. So t is equal to mu into dw into r. So integral from ri to ro, ri to ro integral from ri to ro. So now put the value of dw. So value of dw is here. So t is equal to mu ri to ro. So p into 2 pi r dr into this r. So this is the fourth equation. So the fourth equation is t is equal to mu integral from ri to ro p into 2 pi r dr into r. Now in this p is constant, 2 is constant, pi is constant. So take out from the integral 2 pi mu p. So integral from ri to ro. So r into r is r square dr. Now 2 pi mu p. So integral of this is r cube by 3 from ri to ro. So this 3 come here. So 2 by 3 mu pi mu p. This is ro cube minus ri cube. So this is 2 by 3 pi p mu ro cube minus ri cube. Now put the value of p. Put the value of p. We know the value of p is equal to, we find out, that is equation number 3. We know equation number 3. Equation 3 is p is equal to w divided by pi ro square minus ri square. So equation number 3 is this. So put the value of p. So t is equal to 2 by 3 pi into w divided by pi ro square minus ri square into this ro cube minus ri cube. So pi pi get cancelled. So therefore t is equal to 2 by 3. Mu is remaining, I think. So mu is remaining. So 2 by 3 mu w into ro cube minus ri cube divided by this ro square minus ri square. So this is the torque transmitting capacity of the single plate clutch. Now I can take like this mu w rm. So rm is the mean radius of the friction disc. So mean radius of the friction disc. So this rm is equal to 2 by 3 this. So mean radius is 2 by 3 ro cube minus ri cube divided by ro square minus ri square. So for single plate clutch and for uniform pressure theory, the formula for torque transmitted by clutch is t is equal to mu w rm, and rm is nothing but mean radius, that is 2 by 3 ro cube minus ri cube divided by ro square minus ri square. And this mu is coefficient of friction between that friction contacting surfaces, and w is a total operating force or axial force, and rm is a mean radius of friction. So for torque transmitting capacity, first of all I use uniform pressure theory. Now I am going to find out the torque transmitting capacity of single plate clutch by using uniform wear theory. So when clutch is new, we can use uniform pressure theory, but when clutch is get worn out, so at that time this uniform wear theory is used. So according to this theory, it is assumed that the wear is uniformly distributed over the entire surface area of the friction disc. So this assumption is used for worn out clutches. Now according to this theory, work done by the friction force at R, that is wear. So wear is directly proportional to friction force and rubbing velocity. So wear is directly proportional to friction force and rubbing velocity. So wear is directly proportional to frictional force, that means mu into p, and rubbing velocity is 2 pi r into n. N is a speed in rpm, so n is a speed in rps, so small m I have to use here, small m. So mu p into 2 pi r n. Now mu is constant, we are assuming mu as a constant, 2 constant, pi is a constant, and n is also I assume constant, so Vr is directly proportional to p into r. Now according to this theory, Vr is uniformly distributed over the entire surface, so Vr is constant, so therefore p into r is equal to constant here. P is equal to r is a constant. Now this is the equation 1, so that p is equal to constant divided by r, so that is p is inversely proportional to r. P is inversely proportional to r. Now we require this only, so you know that total axial force, that is equation 1, total axial force, total axial force W is equal to integral from Ri to Ro P into 2 pi r dr, P into 2 pi r dr. Now 2 pi is constant, so integral from Ri to Ro P into r dr. Now this P into r is a constant, that is C, so P into r is equal to C. So 2 pi integral from Ri to Ro into C into dr. Now this C is also constant, so take out, so 2 pi C integral from Ri to Ro into dr. Now integral of dr, so 2 pi C and integral of dr is r, so r Ri from Ro, so 2 pi C, so this is Ro minus Ri, so W is equal to 2 pi C Ro minus Ri. So from this equation, I am considering this equation as 2, so from this equation C is equal to, this goes to denominator, so C is equal to W divided by 2 pi Ro minus Ri. This is the third equation. So now this is the value of C. Now dt, torque transmitting capacity, dt we know, dft into r, tangential force into r, so tangential force is mu dw into r, so total torque transmitted, total torque transmitted, T is equal to integral from Ri to Ro, so take integral of this, so mu dw into r. Now we know dw, the value of dw is 2 p into 2 pi r dr into this r, so that is equal to, now this mu is constant, 2 pi is constant, so 2 pi mu take outside, 2 pi mu, and pr is nothing but constant, so c also constant, so ri to ro, now remaining is 1 r into dr. Now take the integral of r dr, so it is r square by 2, so ri to ro. Now 2 pi mu c, this is ro square minus ri square divided by 2, so 2 get cancelled, so this is pi mu c ro square minus ri square. Now this is t. Now put the value of c, that is equation 3 here, so t is equal to pi mu into w divided by 2 pi ro minus ri into this ro square minus ri square. Now t is equal to, so pi pi get cancelled, 2 is remaining, pi pi get cancelled. Now what about this? So T is equal to mu W divided by this 2 RO minus RI into this. So this can this we can write RO minus RI into RO plus RI. Because A square minus B square is nothing but A minus B plus A minus B into A plus B. So this get cancelled. So remaining is T is equal to 1 half mu W into RO plus RI. So this is the torque transmitted by single plate clutch by using uniform wear theory. Now I can also write it as a mu W into RM. So mu W RM. So RM is a mean radius, and mean radius for wear theory is 1 half RO plus RI. So 1 half RO plus RI is a mean radius of friction disk for uniform wear theory. So this is the torque transmitting capacity of single plate clutch. So I conclude here, summarize here. So for uniform pressure theory, when clutch is new, use uniform pressure theory. For that, torque is equal to mu W RM, and RM is equal to 2 by 3 RO cube minus RI cube divided by RO square minus RI square. And for uniform wear theory, this is for uniform pressure theory, for uniform wear theory, torque is equal to mu W RM, and RM is equal to 1 half RO plus RI. So this is the torque transmitting capacity of single plate clutch.